Hello and welcome to Bunbury Church Online. Join the short 30-minute service. May you experience something of God's great love for you and the whole world. Today we continue with our series, Meaning in the Miracles. And in today's miracle, Jesus heals a man born blind. But first, let's sing our opening hymn, Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise. In today's story, we hear Jesus heals a man born blind, demonstrating he is the light of the world, enlightening a world shrouded in darkness. So let's say the following prayer together. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been, help us to amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And a collect for today. Loving God, open the eyes of our hearts. Give us eyes that can see and ears that can hear your truth each and every day, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, delighted, Joy Parker is going to give today's reflection on Jesus healing a man.
The reading is taken from John chapter 9, verses 1 to 12. Jesus heals a man born blind. As he went along, he saw a man blind from birth. His disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" "Neither this man nor his parents sinned," said Jesus, "but this happened so that the work of God might be displayed in his life. As long as it is day, we must work of him who sent me." Dear. The The reading is taken from John chapter 9, verses 1 to 12. Jesus heals a man born blind. As he went along, he saw a man blind from birth. His disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" "Neither this man nor his parents sinned," said Jesus, "but this happened so that the work of God might be displayed in his life. As long as it is day, we must do the work of him who sent me. Night is coming when no one can work. While I am in the world, I am the light of the world." Having said this, he spit on the ground, made some mud with the saliva, and put it on the man's eyes. "Go," he told him, "wash in the pool of Siloam." This word means sent. So the man went and washed and came home seeing. His neighbours and those who'd formerly seen him begging asked, "Isn't this the same man who used to sit and beg?" Some claimed that he was. Others said, "No, he only looks like him." But he himself insisted, "I am the man." "How then were your eyes opened?" they demanded. And he replied, "The man they call Jesus made some mud and put it on my eyes. He told me, 'Go to Siloam and wash.' So I went and washed, and then I could see." "Where is this man?" they asked him. "I don't know," he said. I tried to look back in time and imagine a blind person in Jesus' day with a begging bowl beside them because they were unable to work or because no one fancied employing them, because surely they must be a sinner. It's hard to think of people gossiping about whether the man himself was a wrongdoer or whether his blindness is a punishment for his parents' sin. Jesus is struggling to correct long-held misperceptions, but he still manages to get his message across. John calls Jesus the light of the world and finds an allegory in the blind man whose eyes are open so that he can see the light Jesus is metaphorically shining on the world with his teaching. Jesus' making of the mud is a sort of consecration, and in applying it, he anoints the man's eyes. And our word for christening comes from the word anointing in Greek. Still on a baptismal theme, Jesus then sends him to wash in the pool of Siloam, whose waters were used ritually in the temple every day. Now, the pool of Siloam was actually found by workers mending a sewer in Jerusalem in 2004, and then it was excavated in 2005. It's a sort of trapezoid shape, 225 feet wide, with steps all round leading into the water. The name Siloam means sent, as the passage tells us, and people who are baptised are sent out. But Jesus is also using it as a way of saying that he was sent from God. Second century paintings in several catacombs near Jerusalem show this chapter was interpreted as baptismal right from early on. The blind man, under repeated interrogation from various bystanders, makes statements of ever-deepening understanding of Jesus. He starts out calling him the man called Jesus, and then he ends up telling the Pharisees that he's a prophet, and finally, in the bit we didn't hear, he says he is from God. I don't know about this, but I understand that someone blind, given their sight through surgery, finds their brain takes a bit of time to make sense of what their eyes are telling them. In which case, this man is probably processing increasing clarity of vision in his eyes and increasing clarity of metaphorical vision simultaneously, and he manages to do it. So, what can we do with this text today? When we look at a newborn baby, it's awfully hard to think of original sin. Geoffrey John suggests there's no reason to suppose that the faithless or the unbaptised are automatically damned. But the fundamental meaning of original sin, he says, still feels like a true diagnosis of us as human beings. The existence of sickness, suffering, COVID, injustice, death, makes us feel alone and exiled in a vast universe whose meaning and purpose can seem far from clear. The power of sin and selfishness in our world can be oppressive. Yet, most of us still have an instinct of believing God. We may wonder at times whether God isn't just a projection of our own needs and longings. Prayer is often hard, and we may wonder if we're just praying into emptiness. This is the spiritual blindness Jesus is trying to address, and it takes the miracle of God's intervention to pierce through it. When we're baptized, the giving of new light in spiritual vision is symbolized by giving a lighted candle with the words, "Shine as a light in the world to the glory of God the Father." Enlightenment and belief are usually partial and gradual. Very few people experience the searing conversion of Saul on the Damascus Road. Even when we think we've made a total commitment to Christ, we may be a bit like Peter and not see the hazards to faith that lie ahead. We may find it convenient to deny we know Jesus. We may be equivocal when it suits. Sometimes we don't realise that we've closed our eyes. Those times we need awareness and to redouble our efforts to pray and make contact with God, who is reaching out to us.
Thanks, Joy, for that brilliant message. Now a musical interlude and Rutter's arrangement of the popular hymn, "Be Thou My Vision."
Be thou my vision.
I'm delighted Barbara Crowley is going to lead us in our prayers.
Lord Jesus, we give thanks to the Father for the world we live in, for the gift so freely given to us, and that we just take for granted. Our reading from St. John's Gospel draws us to the work your Father sent you to do. We are thankful that we will have a little more freedom, and give thanks for all who have worked so tirelessly in the vaccination program. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the church throughout the world, and especially in places where your love is unknown, for the people who give their lives to bring your message to all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, with your Father working through your hands, you made the blind man to see. He was not a sinful man to have this affliction. God's work was to be seen on earth in your hands. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, we bring to you those who are in distress of body, mind and spirit, and those who have lost loved ones and now grieve alone. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, we are not only blind from lack of sight, but how we forget others and discriminate people who are different from us, those whose skin is a different colour to ours, those who have a different faith to us, and those who are disadvantaged. Help us all to open our eyes, hearts and hands to see the light and welcome all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The blind man did as Jesus bid him to do, and his eyes were opened. The man could see and went to tell all around him. Jesus told his disciples he was sent from heaven to earth to do his Father's work and to be the light of the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. At the end of this week, many pupils will leave their junior schools or senior colleges for the summer holidays, and will start afresh in new surroundings in September. Many will feel lost and alone, especially those who will have to leave home and go to university. We pray that they will be kept safe whilst they settle into new environments. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father God, we ask that you walk with us all as we go into a new week. Help us to see those who need help, sometimes just to hold a hand or smile to be given. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Shall we all join together in the prayer that Jesus taught us? Oh, Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, Barbara, for those lovely prayers. So let's sing our final hymn, Open the Eyes of My Heart, Lord.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you.
Lift it up, let me hear you.
Open the eyes of my heart.
So a final blessing. May Christ bring you wholeness of body, mind and spirit, grant you the riches of his grace, and give you his peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be with you and all those you love today and always. Amen. And so on this day we've remembered Jesus healing a man born blind. I leave you with the genius who was blinded during childhood, Ray Charles, and the song that gave birth to soul music, What I'd Say.